argue that civilization meant something different in the past, but if we're to live in the 21st century, I say we define it correctly. To me, civilized means not indulging in acts that would be counter to the values that are reflected by the majority of people. The American people themselves are not necessarily barbaric, but the policies of America are in fact barbaric. They're war crimes, they're crimes against humanity. What I see in America, really, coming from the American perspective, is manipulation after manipulation, indoctrination feeding into that in a propaganda machine that gets the result that's intended. America has lived off of war, and Eisenhower famously said, beware of the military-industrial complex. We can go back to the sinking of the Lusitania, which was a very predictable occurrence when we sent that ship into the waters that were known to have German U-boats. After it sunk, the American people went into a war that they really wanted no part of. Shortly after that, we had World War II. The American people, again, wanted no part of it, and yet Franklin Delano Roosevelt was fully aware of the coming attack by the Japanese fleet and made sure that they would incur maximum casualties on that day. Once again, the American people manipulated into war.
Yes, but even without Pearl Harbor, America would have been dragged into that war because Hitler declared war on America rather than it being the other way around.
It's inevitable that America would go into World War II. But are you saying...
What I'm saying is that the American president knew about a fleet coming to kill American soldiers, sons and daughters, and that he allowed that to happen, and in fact made sure that American sons and daughters were murdered needlessly.
Ken.
Well, we are in a perpetual state of war now, aren't we? Whether we go back to the overthrow of Mossadegh in Iran, CIA coups in Central and South America, we can go back to the Gulf of Tonkin incident, which is acknowledged to be an absolute lie at this point. How about the USS Liberty, in which Israel, America's ally, attacked a U.S. Navy ship for hours and killed 34 U.S. sailors? The Sixth Fleet was then called back. Defenses of that ship were called back by McNamara and Lyndon Johnson. These are all established facts covered up. That was intended to bring us into the Six-Day War and attack Egypt and have the first invasion and occupation of those lands in that time. We have since then had other occurrences, such as 9/11, which is the be-all, end-all of manipulation, to buy into the notion that Osama bin Laden and 19 hijackers are responsible for this event is the height of lunacy. It is the most ridiculous conspiracy of all, and it is the excuse for this so-called war on terror, which is, in fact, a war of terror, committing state-sponsored terrorism to the tune of 1 million dead Iraqis and counting, millions of orphans, and millions of refugees, never mind Afghanistan, and now attacking Pakistan as well.
Sorry? Who is responsible?
Absolutely inside job. The U.S. government and intelligence agencies, including the Mossad agents who were in Liberty Park, who were told to go and capture the event on cameras and admitted to it in Tel Aviv on Israeli television. They obviously had foreknowledge of the event.
So the Israelis are the ones who...
The Israelis and the Americans, they could not have done it without the government and the inside job that was required.
Well, obviously... Can you give us an insight into the disparities?
When it comes to the people, those that are the backbone of America across the spectrum, then America's not a nanny state, and that's what the politicians say. When it comes to the bankers, $1 trillion is brought to bear for the bankers to save them. When it comes to war and the war-making industries, plenty of money can be extracted from the American taxpayer to fund war. But when it comes to taking care of its own people, there is destitution, poverty, hunger, tremendous injustice. Home of the Free has, I believe, the largest prison population in the world, if not certainly one of the biggest prison populations in the world. The working class people are being used up, exploited, sent off to wars, and yet the American government continues to claim that it can't take care of things back home. It's all part of a game, again, that uses us working class people as pawns.
Do you think
it would be wise to face up to it and realize it?
Do you think the American electorate would support higher taxes that are needed to correct this distribution?
No, we don't need to raise taxes. We need to stop fighting wars halfway around the world based on lies and investing insane amounts of money in policies that equate to mass murder. If we do that, all that money would now be freed up for the American people. We don't need to give the bankers $1 trillion. Those are the same people that are running our economies into the ground, living high
Robert
on the hog. So we don't need to raise taxes. We could lower taxes and take care of people.
Let me bring Robert in. America in decline anytime soon?
Absolutely. I believe in catalyzing events, having the ability to really raise people's consciousness and allow them to think again. Let us not underestimate, I will say, that the American people are largely being hoodwinked, and I would even go so far as to say that anyone who believes in the official version of 9/11 has been more than hoodwinked, and I repeat my willingness to debate anyone at this table and beyond on that very subject. I say that the American people have it within their capacity to actually effect change and be the ideal that they wish they were. That is possible.
But if you have no faith in the democratic system as it is, are we talking about another American revolution? You know, what are you talking about with people power?
The first thing I would start with is take control of your media, because the media is passing on information that allows people to be hoodwinked into buying into wars that are based on lies. If that propaganda machine did not exist, you would not be so stupid as to be led into a war that is going to equate to war crimes.
Well, the media is used in all countries to promote wars.
But since America has the most profound impact on the world, and we're talking about America tonight, more than any other nation, they need to take control of their propaganda machine, which is hoodwinking the people. Also, look at the system of indoctrination. Question what you've been told. I, like every other American, grew up believing that my nation was the greatest in the world, that it was the beacon of freedom and democracy. Any critical look at the history of America, especially over the last 100 years, makes it clear that not only is America antagonistic and destroying popular democracy around the world, but without question is the number one terrorist by any reasonable definition of the word.